Hey, in this video I would like to show you how you can get historical data of stock prices and time series of statistical indicators from the Alpha Vantage provider into Excel using Deriscope. Here you can see a few stock tickers that I'm going to use later on. And the easiest way to proceed in order to paste the two required functions in the spreadsheet is to let Deriscope do that job for us. So I'm going to select any empty cell. I'm selecting the cell A1 here on the top. And then I move over to the task pane and I click here, insert function, live feeds, Alpha Vantage, and then time series. This has pasted two functions in the spreadsheet. I will explain these two functions. I'm going to start with the second one, which is a prerequisite for the top function. This, as you see in the formula bar, is called DS, takes input a single range that consists of five rows and two columns. The most important entries are the bottom three rows. As you can read here, they provide the function name, the symbol, and the output size. If you click on any of them, for example, the function name, you can see associated description on the task pane. And if you click here, you can see the several function names that are possible with respect to the Alpha Vantage. We're going to stick with the time series daily that is going to provide us daily series of stock prices. The symbol is chosen to be the MSFT, which is the stock ticker for Microsoft. And the output size can either be compact or full. We're going to use compact, which gives about 100 rows of data. And if you use full, you can get several thousands of data. If you go now to the top function, cell A1, this is actually what sends the request to Alpha Vantage and provides the output in the spreadsheet. It's called DSHIST and takes input two arguments. The first one is the two-letter code AV, which stands for Alpha Vantage. And the second argument is a link to the cell A2, where the object that holds the specification request resides. The output of that function is stored into an object with the handle name that you can read at cell A1. And the contents of that object are directly viewable on the task pane here on the right, which you can see it consists of several columns and rows of data. As I scroll down, it has about 100 rows of data. The next thing I would like to show you is how you can produce this historical data, not only for one stock, but for several stocks. I'm going now here where I have seven separate stock tickers already typed in the spreadsheet. And then on the column next to that, I would try to create specification objects relating to these tickers. So I'm going to select first that object here and then move to that cell. And then on my task pane, on the function selector, I'm going to use a function called clone. This function produces a clone object, a replica object of the original one, and also provides the ability to modify one or more aspects of that object. I'm going to modify here the symbol and paste that function on the spreadsheet using the third option here. Then I'm going to edit slightly this formula. So I'm going to clone that cell and hit F4 because I want to keep that constant as I paste that formula underneath later on. And then the symbol I would like to link to that cell on the left and hit return. The two cells I do not need, and I paste that formula below. So I have here, as I click on that cells, you see these are objects that contain the specification request for the respective tickers. Now on the column to the right, I'm going to produce the actual historical data by typing the function dshist. I have to provide the AV code for Alpha Vantage, and I have to link to that cell containing the specification request object. Close parenthesis, I hit return. This has produced an object that contains the historical data of Microsoft. If I paste that formula down and wait a few seconds in order for all these objects to be created, I'm going to have on my spreadsheet 7 separate objects, which ready now, if you click on any of them, for example, on the Amazon, you can see here on the task pane the time series pertaining to Amazon. If you click on Apple, you see ones for Apple. Fine. Let me show you now how you can get a historical time series of a statistical indicator. So something different than the time series daily. Let me go to another sheet here. Select cell A1. And the first thing, I need to go to my type selector under data, and then live data, and then Alpha Vantage hist spec. Here you can see you have a function name by default set to time series daily. Let me change that to something else, for example, MACD. And here you can see the input parameters that go into this MACD statistical function. I press on go, paste function. This has created the request specification object with respect to the MACD function. Again, as you type here, you can see descriptions of these entries on the task pane. Now, below that, let's say here, I will create the actual time series by typing the function, again, dshist, AV for Alpha Vantage, and then passing this handle name of the request object. Close parenthesis, hit return. And that has created the object that contains the time series with respect to the MACD function. If I click on that cell now, you can see the data here on the task pane, which in this case, it consists of a few columns and several rows. If I scroll down, we have 4,436 rows. You can paste all this data on the spreadsheet if you would rather work on the spreadsheet instead of just viewing the data on the task pane by selecting any cell, for example this one, and then moving over task pane under go paste object content. This has pasted all the data on the spreadsheet. You can see the array formula here, how it is called. And if you scroll down on the spreadsheet, you can go down about 4,000 rows to the end. This is a single array formula. You also have the option to select any cells here. For example, I'm going to select these few cells on the task pane. And then select any empty spreadsheet cell. And finally, go and paste object contents. This is going to paste exclusively only that portion of the range that you have selected on the task pane. And again, this is pasted as an array formula and not just as values. Okay, that has brought me to the end of this talk. Thank you for watching. Bye.